Hi, I'm John Simon. I'm Product and Applications Manager at Intrepid Control Systems. And I'm here today at Testing Expo North America in Novi to talk about TC10, or Automotive Ethernet Power Modem. Power modem in a vehicle is very important to have ECUs in the vehicle wake up and go to sleep to conserve battery power. Prior to Automotive Ethernet, it was much more simple. There was a CAN bus, one device on the CAN bus would wake up, and then consequently every other device on the network would wake up very quickly. These were small processors, all connected to the same wire. As the vehicles evolved and we introduced Automotive Ethernet, Ethernet did not inherently have any power modem capabilities built into it. So in many cases, Automotive Ethernet was used in tandem with CAN, where CAN was basically a network that allowed power modem. Now, in an effort to optimize the vehicle, Automotive Ethernet is integrating a power modem capability, and this is was done by the Open Alliance in Technical Committee 10, or TC10. And what that TC10 defined is a way to decouple power modem functionality from the main processor and encapsulate it within the PHY, or the physical layer that connects the microprocessor to the network. So, whereas without this TC10, an ECU would need to boot up, wake up, and send a wake-up request to another device. It would have to boot up, wake up, send it. So all of these latencies would accumulate from one end of the vehicle to the other, and you would have the vehicle would take, you know, hundreds of milliseconds to fully boot up. By decoupling that functionality from the processor and letting the PHY do it, the PHY can act very quickly. So the PHY can wake up and process a wake up on the order of milliseconds and wake up another PHY in the order of milliseconds. And in doing that, the entire vehicle, all the ECUs can boot up at the same time. So the way this works is the PHY is connected to the microcontroller, microprocessor, and you send and receive commands to it, TC10 commands. So what this simulation does is simulate these commands. So the send sleep request simulates the microprocessor of the ECU sending an MDIO command to the PHY to go to sleep. So I'll send this right now. And what you'll see is the length has gone down, which means the PHY has shut off. Now for wake up, there are two different ways the PHY might wake up. The microprocessor might wake it up, and that's what this wake up means. Request over MDIO, so I'll send that. You'll see the link comes back up very quickly. There's another possibility where the PHY gets woken up by a device outside the ECU, and this is where the wake up would come over a wake pin or a discrete input to the PHY. So I'll put the devices to sleep again. So you see they're asleep. Now I'll send this same wake up. Now it's not a message over MDIO to the PHY, it's a discrete wake up. And you'll see the link status comes back up. So again, this decouples the power modem from the microprocessor, from all the software in the microprocessor, and puts it in the PHY to optimize the vehicle network and optimize the boot time of the vehicle. The PHYs can react very quickly to the wake-ups and then let the processors across the vehicle all boot up in parallel.